Welcome to 24CH, Special Extended Edition. In Episode 4, after a heated Thanksgiving trivia battle, we go back to the ice where injuries play a big role. Brandon Prust tells us what it's like trying to play through them and knowing when to shut it down. And Michael Bournival remembers what it felt like to score his first NHL goal. Let's do this.
That's a great shot. Everybody's smiling.
So how am I going to react?
C'est un gros moment dans ma vie, puis c'est un sentiment incroyable.
On their western trip, Winnipeg is the last stop for the Canadiens. Last season, Stéphane Waite trained goalies for the Stanley Cup-winning Chicago Blackhawks. His long-awaited souvenir has just arrived.
How you doing, man?
These are the good days, right?
You're my Santa Claus. Yeah, t'attendais pas à ça, là. J'ai su hier soir que Al McIsaac, le vice-président des Blackhawks, s'en venait à Winnipeg pour me présenter ma bague de la Coupe Stanley.
Steph. Congratulations from the Chicago Blackhawks.
Thank you very much.
And present your 2013 Stanley Cup ring. Rocky Wirtz and the entire organization, thank you for your contributions. I hope you appreciate it. Hope you enjoy it. Take a look. Maybe open it up.
Thank you very much, eh? Wow. Thank you very much. Thank you. I'm so fortunate to work with the Hawks for 10 years and now with the Montreal Canadiens, two of the best organizations in the league. So thank you.
We'll try it on.
Oh yes, I can't wait. Oh, that's always something special, huh? That's perfect fit. That's fit right there. Wow, what a ring, huh?
C'est ma deuxième avec les Blackhawks. Et puis, c'est toujours spécial. C'est aussi spécial que la première.
We also have something for Annie, as you know.
Oh, yeah?
Take care of your wife. The pennant is a commemorative of the Stanley Cup as well. So, again,
just like,
congrats.
Wow, thank you very much.
Tell her that we appreciate all that she did as well.
She'll be very happy. Wow, that's perfect.
Je me sens chanceux d'en avoir deux. C'est un, mais il est temps de travailler fort pour essayer d'en avoir une troisième.
Short warm-up drills.
It's crucial to remember that the puck bounces differently in each arena.
Avant chaque pratique, on teste les bandes, voir comment ils réagissent. La rapidité, les bons, les rebonds.
Look at that. Everywhere, that's the same.
Everything goes in front.
Everything. That's a perfect pass. Both sides. That's unbelievable. C'était pas de clear lane. Là. Shoots a red light ou Boston Pizza, là, ça va direct dans le blue paint. Les deux bars, c'est incroyable.
The shot's gonna miss the net.
So
rotate, move to the post.
Last one.
Oh, great save.
Wow. You just need a perfect shot to beat my guys. Stay big, stay square, be patient. You got nothing. Right. You know why they miss the net all the time, huh? Because they got nothing.
Thanksgiving dinner. Let's play Trivial Pursuit on the history of the Montreal Canadiens.
It's Thanksgiving today, and I don't like to play for nothing. I like to play for something, as you guys know. So the winner will get a gift certificate.
Is that good enough for you, Prusty, or you wanted something else?
I wanted some power play time.
Nobody agreed with that. I guess nobody wants me on the power play.
Team Bournival, Alex Galchenyuk is the second youngest American-born player to have played with the Habs. 18 years old in 142 days. Who was the first one? 30 seconds.
Oh, wow, that was quick.
Final answer?
Chelios?
No, not Chelios.
Matthew Schneider.
Matthew Schneider is the right answer.
Oh, that's
U.S. college with the most players drafted at the NHL entry draft overall.
Right hand or left hand?
Left.
What was this again?
Boston?
No.
Oh, no.
Boston College?
No. Michigan is right with 70.
Michigan.
Two brothers who played with a Canadian, an extra 5 points if they played together. Henri Richard and Maurice Richard, 10 points.
Here's the challenge. Name five of the 10 teams that assistant coach Jean-Jacques Demieux has played for.
I can only remember three.
Yeah, the other one. All-time NHL win leader among American-born goalies. Yes, sir. Let's do the follow points, guys.
Lars Eller's table wins.
I don't like that. Don't like losing.
The next evening, the team faces the Jets. Stefan Waite is proud to show off his Stanley Cup ring to the other coaches.
What about two? Huh? That's better than the f***. What about two?
Can't hear it. I got my two Stanley Cup lock in my ear.
Maybe it's not cool. We're missing it. Oh boy, that's just a tough beat. I want to play balls. I want to play balls.
Let's make sure we're going to play hard, discipline. Our intensity should drop penalty. So this is what we're looking for tonight. And right now we're having a good trip. We get a chance to making a great trip. All right, gamer wants to f*** more. All right, come on.
During their warm-up, the players seem determined to make this trip a great one. The Canadiens face the Jets. Prust scores the first goal.
Hear that, PK? It's the arm of Wayne. Hit the side of the net. It bounces in front.
Then PK adds one. Pacioretty is injured. A tough night in Winnipeg.
Play behind the D. Work for it. Good transition. Let's make sure we go back and where we started. They can't keep up with their pace. So let's make sure we take pride out of it. All right, come on.
Second period. The Jets try to slow the Canadiens down. Carey Price is on top of his game. Vigneault offers valuable advice to his defensemen.
Let's play a smart game. We don't want to give any young man rushes. So offensively, defensively, let's manage the puck better. Play a smart game, okay, guys? We're playing well. We're playing well. Just a couple of bad decisions at the end, okay?
In the third period, Daniel Briere closes the deal.
For his first as a Canadian, and that'll make it 3-0.
No hope left for the Jets. The Habs win 3-0, but Max Pacioretty is a big loss. The Canadiens are back in town.
Gusker.
For Gallagher, going home means heading back to George's.
One of my best friends was coaching for the Kelowna Rockets, and he was playing in Vancouver, and they told me about him coming to Canada. They said, you gotta watch this kid. He's gonna be good. He's small, but he plays hard. So being a Western guy, you know, we kind of look out for each other a little bit. And I made sure I went up to him right away and introduced myself to Gap, and you know, he was a pretty good kid, so we kind of clicked right away. Initially, when they asked me if I was interested in having one of the young guys stay, I thought that was going to be the biggest problem was, you know, like my wife wants to have another person in the house. We want to be just the two of us, but they've gotten along real well, better than I thought.
I don't know what I bring to this relationship, but they keep me around for some reason. Whenever they're ready to kick me out, I'll leave.
We're in no rush to kick him out, but I'm sure at some point he'll want to be on his own.
All right.
when I first got here too, that none of this existed out here. I mean, we didn't have a practice facility, so no one even thought to live out in this area.
Hi, guys.
Hello.
Hey. Hi.
How are you?
Good. How are you?
Very good.
How did you get this?
Get that? Oh. Let's go in my... Thank you very much.
You're
welcome.
Where's
this going to go? In my room, collection room.
Say hi. You're on 24CH, too.
Thank you very much.
Back at the training center, Thérien meets with Paris, who is in much better shape now.
Rough start.
Come on in, we got a quick meeting for fun.
Veteran Francis Bouillon celebrates his 38th birthday. Thérien hands out prizes to the Winnipeg quiz winners.
I am here to give the prize for the trivia. Team Larry won. Mo, $150 actually. Remember? Yeah. Chucky, congratulations. Did a good job. Larry, good work. Andre, good job.
Merci.
Mario. Dominique Saillant was part of the team. Congratulations. Okay.
We did a recounting, and I promise you,
no way.
With John Sedgwick,
no
the
way.
Team of Lars Eller is the winning team.
No way.
We did a recounting.
No way. You weren't right there.
And if there's a rematch on November 21st, we'll have another format, I promise. Thanks again.
René Bourque is stricken by the flu. Will he be in tonight's lineup? Beaulieu is training. He needs to be ready. There's no doubt, Max Pacioretty will not be playing tonight. He's got the blues as only a benched player can.
Five game at home. We got five coming up. It's time to be homers. All right, we did a great job on the road, but the road means nothing if we're not playing the right way at home. All right, come on, let's go.
Despite his bad case of flu, Bourque will play. Beaulieu's gonna have to wait his turn.
All right, we need to use our speed. This is our big asset. Take good decision with the puck. I mean, no turnovers. When we're coming to the neutral zone, take what they're gonna give you. Offensively, manage the puck all the time. Hey, okay? Out there, good start like we did last game. Come on, let's go. There you go.
The Canadiens face Columbus's Blue Jackets in front of their fans. Gallagher is slashed in the face, but the foul goes unpunished. Neither his flu nor the opposing goalie can stop Bourque. He scores the first goal. Then Michael Bournival scores his first ever goal in the NHL.
Ouais, je pense que j'avais fait une couple de fois quand j'étais jeune ce rêve-là de pendant la nuit. Puis j'avais des frissons, je me rappelle, ça avait duré deux minutes, je pense, mes frissons. C'est vrai que c'était vraiment un rêve qui se réalisait, puis c'était un moment que je ne vais jamais oublier. Ben, c'est pour ça que j'ai des frissons. Tu sais, moi, quand le monde crie, ça me motive, ça me donne des frissons toujours. Puis ça a été la même chose pendant les playoffs. À chaque fois qu'on a embarqué ça, là, c'est, le monde il criait, puis ça donne des frissons, ça donne de l'énergie.
This is where we're gonna have success. All right? I'm gonna play f***ing there. All right? Keep it up. We gotta win the second period. That's the mentality. Not on our f***ing heel, on our toes. Let's win the second period. Let's go. Come on. Come on,
boys.
Bournival is still on cloud nine. He'll never forget this moment.
Come on, man, let's go now. Make time, come on.
Start of the second period. The referee gives PK Subban a penalty.
What? Montreal belly number 76, minor belly elbowing.
Markov scores, even though the CH is shorthanded. But the coach is still fuming. Jenner is the first to score for Columbus.
Out, 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 out!
Before the end of the second period, the CH only have a one-goal advantage.
All right, we need to get the momentum back by skating, by competing, strong on puck, and make sure we're gonna be smart out there. We wish to get the 3-goal lead. There's nothing we can do. We got a 1-goal lead. We get to the third, Winner wants to f***ing win, and this is what we're gonna do. We're gonna be f***ing hard, and we're gonna be smart. All right, come on, let's go.
Come on,
we know it's a big game to win. Let's go.
Right here, boys.
Third period. Jenner scores his second goal of the game, evening the odds. Plekanec handles the situation. Two goals in 23 seconds. The win is in the bag. Murray, Paris, and Emelin, still injured, enjoy the show. Their return home is a successful one. A wonderful birthday gift for Bouillon. As for Bournival, he's not likely to forget tonight's game.
C'est vrai que c'est là que j'ai eu le plus de frissons. Tu sais, ça a duré quand même assez longtemps, j'étais content. Puis, c'est vrai que ça sortait de moi, tellement que j'étais heureux. Là. C'était direct sur ma palette, donc je croirais pas, j'aurais été déçu. C'était comme un jeu parfait. C'est sûr que ça va être sur une tablette dans ma chambre. C'est sûr que je vais vouloir regarder à tous les jours. C'est un gros moment dans ma vie, puis c'est un sentiment incroyable.
Today's the official photo shoot for the Canadiens 2013-2014 team.
Okay. Everybody take your positions and look at the camera over here. We'll go for one, two, three. Everybody looking over here. That's a great shot. Everybody smiling.
Perfect. Thank you very much.
Prust and Galchenyuk are true to their natures. They wrestle each other whenever they can.
Well, I mean, by judging of the clip, it's easy to say I'm the winner, right? I'm celebrating, right? Well, now after we're done fighting, he thinks he wants to get back at me. And he got a couple of good punches on me there. Went to chill in the penalty box a little bit. Time to go home.
He always starts it. See, he always starts it. I never really go after him.
Look for attention for a second, please.
Hey, guys. How's it going?
Good.
I just want to take 2 minutes of your time. First of all, congratulations on a great road trip and a nice win last night. It's great for all of us, for you guys for sure, but for the fans to see you guys off to a great start. So thanks a lot for that, and keep it up. I just wanted to tell you very briefly about something that an initiative that we've taken on for you guys. We've decided that given that you're in a unique market where most of the population speaks French, that we're going to offer you guys French classes if you want them. It's totally voluntary. But it's something that we believe as an organization is important to offer to you guys. It can be helpful. The expectations are not that you're going to be speaking, doing interviews in French, from these lessons. I think it's more so you can say some, have some expressions with the media or with fans, thank them, be kind to them, or whatever it is you decide you want to learn in the French language. I think it's a good place to learn. And, you know, we've got some Russians here and some Swedes, and I'm sure in your local market. It would be appreciated by your people as well to learn the local language. So it's going to be offered to you guys. It's totally voluntary, but hopefully some of you will embark on it and enjoy it and learn a new language. So good luck with it. It starts next week, and Donnell will follow up with the rest of it. All right? Thanks.
The gigantic Paros skates for the first time since his concussion.
How does it feel?
Good. Yeah.
It's been a while.
Yeah. Happy?
Yeah. A little bit slower. Okay.
Good job, Benny.
That's it, Benny. Thank you, buddy.
Good job, Benny. Team meeting. Terrien gets his message across to Tinordi with humor.
In your own end, there's 30 plays, tenor in the NHL, you can make. A turnover is in your back end. Do you know where is it?
What's that?
There's 30 plays in the defensive zone that you can make. You can make turnovers in your own end. Do you know where?
No.
Somebody knows?
Montreal, Toronto, Pittsburgh,
you can't do that.
Phoenix,
you can't do that. Other places?
Colorado.
You can't turn the puck over in your back end, your own end. And other places? All right, make sure you won't happen again. All right, let's go.
After warm-up, Nathan Beaulieu packs up and returns to Hamilton.
Good one, eh, boys?
He's determined to travel back as soon as possible.
Monday.
It's never a good feeling, but, you know, just work my way back up again.
Brière and Desharnais talk strategy.
Let's make sure we got the right mindset to approach tonight's game. It's pretty simple. Continue the attack tonight. Hey, attack their defensemen. Go to the net hard. We want to be physical, but in the meantime, we want to be disciplined. All right, come on.
Predators versus Canadians. The game begins. Desharnais' trio buzzes around the opponent's end zone.
Yep.
The Predators make good use of their numerous power plays and score the first goal.
Could be worse. It's 1-0.
Got to be back. We've got to stay on the ice.
We got to play. We want to be on the ice.
It's impossible to use our personal to stay intense, right?
I'm ready to play.
So we've got to move that puck right off. Waiting 1 or 2 seconds, but we don't have any options. Up.
And they beat us in every aspect, that curious.
Every fucking aspect. Face off. Everything. Puck control, forecheck, everything.
What's going on? It's simple. Are we getting hard work? Foot raise, not there. Are we having fun? Like that type of game?
No.
As a group, how are we going to react now? We got to react. What are we going to do?
Work our asses off. Keep it simple. Start skating. First on puck.
You have the commitment from everyone that we're gonna change our f-ing mindset?
Yes.
Rusty?
Chucky?
Chucky?
Yep.
second period.
Blindside cheap shot.
Daniel Briere leaves the ice, dizzy. Gallagher evens the score. While Price keeps his team within reach of a win.
On a match, un peu dans l'intensité. La troisième, we have to be all over.
Everybody battle, come on. Show your energy level there. Earn your f***ing days off tomorrow. Ready to go. Come on, boys, let's go.
Let's go, man. Come on, let's go.
Third period. Yeah. The Canadians think they're ahead, but the goal is being disputed. The referee hands out the final decision. The goal is disallowed. It's still 1-1. Therrien demands an explanation.
You want me to give you an explanation? Okay. I'll be very honest with you. I'm watching leg one. He cross-checked the guy. I'm calling the penalty. I look down. I thought I saw the puck over the line. The guy tell me it wasn't over the line. Confirmed by the replay.
This guy can confirm that the blue line is
three guys did. Three guys.
Blue line.
That's it.
This hurts. The next catch. Right in front of his girlfriend, Marie-Pierre Morin. That hurt. I love the music though they're playing here. Like, just the saddest day ever. Listen to the music. It almost made me cry. I was just thinking, not again. Other shoulder. This music, oh my God, depressing. Like, sometimes you just have pain where it's just pain for maybe a minute or something, and then you can kind of go back out there. So you're trying to see if the pain will go away, but I mean, sometimes you know that there's something wrong, more than just a stinger like that. I knew there was something wrong with the joint or whatever, the bone, or you pull the muscle or something.
Well, that's something serious, you usually know right away.
Rookie Seth Jones.
You usually know right away, but you always have that hope that it's not as serious as maybe you think, you know, like sometimes you just, sometimes it can go away, you can go back out, like even blocking a shot. I remember I blocked a shot on my foot one time, and like in my mind I was like, no way, I think I broke it. And eventually you realize it goes away and it's not broken. So, but I mean, sometimes you actually, you're just hoping it's not that bad.
CH Premiere, 24 hours before everyone else, only with the Bell TV app.